So in case of Java, every literal is considered as of integer type. But if you want to specify that the literal is of long type, then you have to specify a small l or capital L. Now let me show you a simple example here. What do I mean to say by all these statements? As you know, there are four types of variable by which we can store integer numbers in Java. We have byte, we have short, we have integer, and we have long. Now all these four types of variables are going to store integer numbers, as you know, and already I specified what is the size of the value, or you can say what is the maximum and minimum number that you can store between these variables. Okay. Now let us take four data types, four variables here. We have A, B, C, and D, and let me assign them some values. If I say it byte A is equal to 10, short B is equal to 10, integer C is equal to 10, and long D is equal to 10. Now all these are perfectly correct. Why? See, you know the size of byte is of only 1 byte. The size of short is of 2 bytes. The size of integer is of 4 bytes. And the size of long here is of 8 bytes. Okay. Now according to the size, the maximum and the minimum number that can be stored inside these variables is decided. For example, in case of byte, what is the minimum number that can be stored? That is minus 2 raised to power 7. And what is the maximum number that can be stored? That is plus 2 raised to power 7 minus 1. Or you can say it is minus 128 to plus 127. So this is the range of the number that you can store in a byte variable. Now this number 10 is automatically in this range. That is why if you give an integer literal to this byte variable, and if that byte, if the integer literal is automatically that is in the range, then this, there is no kind of error and it will automatically convert this integer literal of type byte. Okay. Now if I say I try to give byte A is equal to 1000. Now in this case, this integer literal is, the value of this integer literal is out of the range of the byte. Now in that case, it is going to give you an error by saying that possible loss of precision, that is, there will be a compile time error. Now here same happens with the short. Now short B is storing 10. Now this 10 is again in the range of the numbers that a short can store. Therefore automatically this number, this integer literal is converted to short, and here integer C is equal to 10. So it is by default every integer literal in the form of integer. Now this is a special case here again. In long D is equal to 10. Now you know what is the range of the numbers that long variable can store. So the size of the long variable is of 8 bytes. Now because the size of 8 bytes, therefore if I say long D is equal to 10, that means this number is actually an integer number. This number is not a long number. Mind you, this number is an integer number, it is not a long number. And the size of integer number or the range of the integer number is less than the range of a long number. Therefore, automatically it can be stored. But if you try something like this, that integer C is equal to 10L and long D is equal to 10L. Now, in this case, when I say integer C is equal to 10L, when I suffix an integral number by L, that means I am specifying that this integral number is of type long. So this assignment cannot be done here because the size of long is much bigger as compared to the size of integer. Therefore, you can say this 10L, if you assign it with the integer C, so it is going to give you a compile time error. It is going to say that possible loss of precision, required integer, but you are giving me a long number. In the same way, when I say long D is equal to 10L, now this is perfectly correct. Why? Because this L specifies that it is a long number, and obviously you can insert this long number into this long variable. Correct? So if I create variables like this, now if I try to do C is equal to B and B is equal to A, that is perfectly fine because here you can see B is of type short and A is of type, this is of type short and A is of type byte. So every byte number can be stored in the form of short variable. So when you do B is equal to A, so whatever the decimal number that you are going to come, that is going to come inside B, so that decimal number will be converted to a short type. Okay, so here variable will not be converted, but the number will be converted. In the same way, C is of type integer, but B is of type short. So you can store a short variable into C. But if I do something like this, C is equal to D. Now D is of type long. Therefore, you cannot store a long variable into a integer variable because the size of long is much bigger than the size of integer. So there's a table here. As you can see, you can store a byte number in a short variable. You can store a short number in an integer variable. In the same way, you can store a character in an integer variable because the byte size of byte is 1 byte. It is of 2 bytes. This integer is of 4 bytes. And here you can see the character is also of 2 bytes. So because these are short, smaller data types, therefore you can store these smaller data types into integer and they will not be having any kinds of errors. But if you try to store this short into a byte, if you try to store a short number into a byte variable, then what will happen? There will be a compile time error which will say that a possible loss of precision required a short variable type, but you are giving a byte. Actually, for byte required a byte variable type, but you are giving a short. So this is a table specifying hierarchy that you can store every byte number to short, every short number to integer, every integer number to long, every long number to float, and every float number to double. So there's a different way how this float and double numbers are stored as compared to this short, int, and long. Because here byte, short, integer, and long, to represent a negative number, they use 2's complement method. But in case of float and double, to represent actually any number, there's a different way of doing this, because in float and double we have IEEE format which specifies the number of precision of the bits as well as precision of the numbers as well as how you can store them. So I'm going to cover that at later point of time, where how I'm going to tell you how a decimal number is stored inside a float variable, and accordingly you can find it out. So it is much convenient for us to store a float number here, what is an exponent and what, how you store the powers and everything. So that I'm going to discuss at later point of time. Okay. Now let me take a simple example here. If I say long I is equal to 10L, that is perfectly fine because 10 is a, you can see 10 is a long number. But if I say integer j is equal to 10L, now it is not fine because that is going to give you a compile time error by saying possible loss of precision found long but required integer. So just, I've just taken a simple example here. So I'm doing byte b1 is equal to 5. So if I say byte b1 is equal to 5, now you can say this b1, this 5 is a decimal number. And this decimal number is actually in the range of the byte variable. Therefore, it will be automatically stored into this and there will not be any kind of error. Now, if I say byte b2 is equal to 0b1101. Now, here, this b is a small b. So, you can either write as a capital B or small b. Both of them are fine. I can write it as 0b1101 or I can write it as 0B1101. That means this number that is given here, it is a binary number. So what is the data that will be stored in B2? So you have to convert this 1101 from binary to decimal. And if you convert this, you can find it out, its decimal value here is 13. So decimal number 13 will be stored in B2. Now, if you want to represent a negative number, so this is actually representing plus 13. But here, because I have written minus sign here, so therefore this B3 will be storing minus of 13. Now you can see in byte B5, what I have done is I have used an underscroll here. So I can write 0B11. So this Java SE7 allows you a feature that if you are writing any integral literal, now you can use scroll anywhere in the between that integral literal. For example, I have written 0B11101 underscroll 0. So what does it mean? It actually means this is the same. For example, this number here, it is going to print the value which is 2 and this is 8. So it is going to print the value 10. In the same way, this number is also going to print you the value 10. Now, for example, here I've taken a long variable which is long credit card number, and I can write the entire number exactly. So number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and so on. So, but if you write a credit card number like this, so it will be very difficult to remember sometimes. And it will be very difficult to understand that this is a credit card number. Therefore, the Java allows you a feature that you can use this underscore anywhere in the number. So you can use 123 underscore 5678 underscore 9101 underscore 1121. Now this credit card number is actually, this is this number and this number is exactly the same. The only difference is I'm using underscore between these numbers, and this underscore is just doing, it is just improving the readability of the number. It's not having any kind of meaning. Just for example, if I write a numbers like this, one like this, right? So this is representing a number which is 1 lakh. Now we use this comma sign here in any number. We use this comma sign here so that we can improve the readability of the number. Otherwise, you have to calculate it is ones, tens, hundreds, so on. But just because of this comma sign, it is much easier to read the number. In the same way, we can use underscroll in Java, which can improve the readability of the number. So where can you use this underscroll? So you can place this underscroll only between the digits, but you cannot place this underscroll at the beginning and end of the digit. For example, if I say that integer a, it is equal to underscroll 12. Now this underscroll cannot be used in the beginning of the digit, because if you use in the beginning, now this will be considered as a string. In the same way, you cannot use this underscroll adjacent to the decimal point in the floating point literal. You cannot use this underscroll prior to f or l suffix. F or l suffix. For example, if I write here integer or let us say long b is equal to 12 underscroll l. Okay. Now here you cannot write it like this. Okay. So you cannot use it prior to f or l suffix. In the same way, you cannot use this underscroll in position where a string or a digit is expected. So there's a limitation where you can use this underscroll, and somewhere you cannot, there are some places where you cannot use this underscroll. So let me do one thing, let me rub the board and let me take one example where of the numbers or the variable types where I'm just specifying what are the locations where you can use underscroll and what are the location where you cannot use underscroll at all. Okay, so let me rub it up and let me get back to you.